If you could write about anything in the whole wide universe, what would it be? Would you write about a space bum traveling through the galaxy, hitching on blue comets here and there? Or would you write about a day at the lake, fishing in cabins for father and son? Or about a bear who is not a bear, or butterflies outside your window? Whatever you write about, please believe in it. If there is any one thing a person must know about writing, it is this. You must believe in what you write. If not, it isn't good writing. But how does one get around to writing a novel, a memoir, script, screenplay, short story, flash fiction, fan fiction? Where do you start? Do you start with an idea, a theme, plot, character, setting, action, object, dialogue, beginning, middle, end? Actually, it doesn't matter. As long as you have a basic premise demonstrated in terms of human behavior. What is a premise? A premise is a thesis, purpose, a proposition stated or assumed as leading to a conclusion, a guide showing you the road to take. For example, what is the premise of Macbeth? Remember, in the play Macbeth and Lady Macbeth, in their ruthless ambition to fulfill a prophecy of being king and queen, decide to kill King Duncan. Then, to strengthen and secure his position, Macbeth hires assassins to kill Banquo, whom he fears. Afterwards, his orders of execution increase to secure his position further. Finally, the nobles and his own subjects become so aroused that they rise against him, and Macbeth perishes as he lived, by the sword. Lady Macbeth dies of haunting fear. What can be the premise of this play? We know the motivating force in the drama is ambition, a ruthless ambition, since it is drenched in blood. Macbeth's downfall was foreshadowed in the very method by which he achieved his ambition. The premise for Macbeth is, ruthless ambition leads to its own destruction. Confused? Think of premise as a GPS in your car. The premise takes your starting place and ending destination to compute specific directions, making sure you get there. In Macbeth, the premise tells us that we will begin with a ruthless ambition and end with its own demise. In every good play, there must be a premise, and every good premise is composed of three parts. Let us examine Macbeth's premise once again. Ruthless ambition leads to its own destruction. The first part of this suggests character, a ruthless, ambitious character. The second part, leads to, suggests conflict. And the third part, destruction, suggests the end of the play. The three parts of a premise, then, is 1. Character, 2. Conflict, and 3. The end of the play. Try formulating a premise from the following. A man is so frugal, he denies himself bare necessities. His frugality is such that he loses more in the end than he gains.
If your answer resembles frugality leads to waste, then you have a good premise. We can see the first part of the premise here, the second part here, and the third part here. This premise, or GPS, suggests the one and only road you must take. Many premises can deal with frugality, but in your case, there will be only one motivating power which will drive your play to its inevitable conclusion. So in order for your premise to be effective, it must be clear-cut, active, and worded so that anyone can understand it as the author intended it to be understood. Here is an example of an ineffective premise. Love defies all. Although it is not a bad idea, it is an ambiguous statement. It says too much and therefore says nothing. What is this all? You might answer that it is obstacles, but we can still ask, what obstacles? And if you say that love can move mountains, we are justified in asking, what good will that do? In your premise, you must designate exactly how great this love is, show exactly what its destination is, and how far it will go. A better premise is, great love defies even death. This premise designates the road the lovers will travel. They will die for love. It is active, so that when you ask what love will defy, it is possible to answer death. As a result, you not only know how far your lovers are willing to go, you also have an inkling as to the kind of characters they are, the characters they must be to carry the premise to its logical conclusion. In case you are wondering, you can see this premise in Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet and in many other works. Here are a few other premises. No one premise is necessarily a universal truth. All of these premises contain all that is required of a well-constructed premise: character, conflict, and conclusion. However, these are only flat statements. Why? Because the author's conviction is missing. Until he takes sides, there is no play. Only when he champions one side of the issue does the premise spring to life. Does prudishness lead to frustration? Which side will you take? We, the readers or spectators of your play, do not necessarily agree with your conviction. Through your play, you must therefore prove to us the validity of your contention. And to prove that fully, you should believe in it. The premise should be a conviction of your own, so that you may prove it wholeheartedly. Perhaps it is a preposterous premise to me. It must not be so to you. When proving your premise, the audience must be able to know what the message is. However, you should never mention your premise in the dialogue of your play. The premise should not stand out like a sore thumb, turning the characters into puppets and the conflicting forces into a mechanical setup. In a well-constructed play or story, it is impossible to denote just where premise ends and story or character begins. Neither the premise nor any other part of a play has a separate life of its own. All must blend into a harmonious whole. All this talk about premise does not mean you can't start a play without one. You can arrive at your premise in any one of a great many ways. You can start with a character, or an incident, or even a simple thought. This thought or incident grows, and the story slowly unfolds itself. You may start with an idea, which you at once convert to a premise, or you may develop a situation first and see that it has potentialities which need only the right premise to give them meaning and suggest an end. You have time to find your premise in the mass of your material later. The important thing is, to find it.